Hi everybody, and welcome back to the Sony Music Archives. I'm Tom Tierney, and we're here in the photo library at Sony Music today, and we're going to be checking out some really cool materials relating to our Artist of the Month for March 2013, Sly Stone. Now, Sly recorded for Epic Records, one of our labels, for about a decade, from 1967 to 1976, and we've pulled out a lot of really cool stuff to check out from that incredible band. I'm here with our photo library manager, Che Williams. And Che has a background in both film photography and digital photography. So he is really our expert for everything in the photo library. How you doing, Che?
Hi, I'm good, how are you?
Thanks for joining us today and checking out some stuff. I brought something specifically down to show you because I knew you'd think it was awesome. This is an advertisement for Sly Stone's Greatest Hits album that came out towards the end of 1970. And look at that. How great is that? Check that out.
His boots are hot. Love the boots.
It's cool. Yeah.
Absolutely.
This was from Flip Magazine, the January 1971 issue of Flip Magazine, which apparently was America's most trusted teen magazine. And my favorite feature was page 8, Ask Karen Valentine. So
that's pre-Tiger Beat.
I think it is, yeah, something like that. Or a competitor, we don't know. So we've got advertisements and all sorts of great stuff in the photo library. And one thing in particular that I wanted to bring out was the way our photo library is laid out for the black and white stuff is we have contact sheets for our black and white negatives. And this is a great contact sheet from March of 1969, right around the time of the recording of the Stand album. And this was a photograph taken by photographers from what was at the time CBS Records. And this has some, this contact sheet has some particularly great images of Sly on it. Now, here are the corollary negatives for this shoot. Che, can you explain to us what those materials are?
These are 6x6 or 2.25 black and white negative images of the actual Sly Stone shot in the studio. I don't know what studio it was taken in, but these are the actual original hard negatives that were used during this shoot.
Yeah, most of our Sly stuff was shot on the West Coast, so it was probably some like CBS creative office.
He was a West Coast artist.
San Francisco artist, yeah.
So yeah, someone like me, I'm sure these were over there.
So what Che does is that not only does he make all the photographs available to researchers here in the library, but he also makes digital versions of these original photo materials. In this case, it's 44 years old. We have materials like these negatives going back 60 and 70 years.
And they're very priceless.
Yes, extremely, extremely irreplaceable.
There are no duplicates of these. This is it.
Yeah. Can you take us through the process by where you digitize these old negatives?
Well, what I would normally do is, you know, someone would come and choose the shots, and I once they chose what they wanted, I would take what they need, and behind me I would use my scanner and my my Macintosh, and I would digitize the image straight from this right into my hard drive, and save it and email it. It's pretty straightforward, you know. But I don't have to do any retouching or any sort of altering of the image. And once it goes to the art department and the art director will look it over, it gets put into packaging and then gets put on shelves. So, but it usually starts here first. It goes to this computer and then sent digitally to wherever it needs to go. So it's pretty easy.
Cool. Can you take us through the process of that scanning over there on that machine?